on bigger boats where the mainsail can be a lot to handle. It can be easier if you have something like a Mack Pack with built-in lazy jacks. And here's how we installed it.
I've installed many of these Mack Packs over the years, so I know how it's done and measured, but I'll go through it to show you how to do it. So when you go to their website at Mack Sales, you can download this Mack Pack measurement sheet. And they need three measurements here. You want to start with the A, which is from the top of the boom to the top of the sail as it sits furled on the boom. And so in this case, that was 36 inches. Then they want two measurements along the boom. I'm going to take that to 12 inches above the boom at the topping lift. And the B measurement is there to the mast. And then the C measurement is there to the mast at the top of the boom. And in this case, the B is 14 foot 10, and the C 14 foot 9. Okay. Then they want to know the approximate mainsail hoist, which is the P dimension. So you can hoist a tape measure up there to get that if you don't have it. And choose the sunbrella fabric color. In this case, we're getting Captain Navy. And this is Nicholson 31. It's got a P of about 35 foot. They just need a rough dimension so that you can see how far up you'll have to go to install the lazy jacks. All right, the Mack Pack arrives here with the sail cover and instructions and a package of fasteners and cleats, and the lazy jack lines are here. Next, I'm going to go up the mast with these two lines that have the blocks on the ends and install the cheek blocks on the mast, one on each side, with these included bolts. I'm bringing up the tap for number 1028 in the drill. And I've got a mastmate mast ladder I'm going to go up with. But I'm also going to have the bosun's chair so I can sit up there and work. Okay, we're up here at 28 feet there above the boom. And pause for a minute to enjoy the view. St. Simon's Island there, and just around that first corner is the ocean inlet, and in the background is Jekyll Island, St. Simon's Sound. This is the Frederica Yacht Club. And the Intracoastal Waterway is the next river in the background. And that's the causeway to the mainland of Brunswick. That high bridge right there is where the Intracoastal goes under. And this marina here is Morningstar. It's got good protection from the north, east, and west. But we're rather exposed to the south for about 3.5 to 4 miles of open fetch, except for that small floating breakwater there. That's also the anchorage where that boat's anchored out. Right, back to work then. Mount this cheek block here at 28 feet in this case, and I'm going to angle it slightly aft at the bottom for a fair lead and position it just a little aft of the center line of the mast, and I'm going to run the drill through the top hole just to mark it, and then I'll set it aside and drill it and tap it. And once the top screw is in, you can align it and then use that as a guide for drilling the bottom hole. And then don't forget to, after you tap this hole, put some Lanacote on the machine screws before you put them in. Make sure that this block is on the aft side, and then lower both ends down, and then repeat on the other side. Okay, next we tie the upper aft end of the Mack Pack to the topping lift about a foot above the boom, and then loosely tie the bottom so it's about straight down from the top to the end of the boom, and have the zipper closed so it's easier to work with. And then we go forward. I'll take the bottom. And we'll mark where this one can go. On this boat, there's a winch right in the way of where we wanted to install this forward lower end of the pack. You're supposed to pull it tight, even with the top of the boom, and it would normally go about there. But there's some flexibility with it, so I'm going to put it there. And what I did was the twist fastener, I drilled the top hole 1/8 inch and put the number 6 screw in there with a drop of multi-caulk on the end, or you could use Lanacote. And then once it's lined up, put the bottom screw in at an angle that matches the grommet. I pulled this taut and installed this fitting here at a 45 degree angle, and then we'll install the center twist snap, and then the same on the other side. Next, I pull taut the A line that has the block in it, and you check that the angle that it passes from the mast through the Mack Pack forward grommets down to the boom is a straight angle there between all the points, and then install a cleat on the lower portion of the boom, and same on the other side. It can get a little confusing at this point as you lead lines B and C through, but you can refer to this diagram they send you and you'll be able to figure it out. First, we have led line B through that upper block and lined it up through the Mack Pack to the bottom of the boom where we installed an eye strap and tied off the end of B, and then we took line C and threaded it through the bronze grommet in line B, and that'll go through the next set. And the third line starts by knotting here, then it goes up through the thimble on the second line back down to the aftmost eye strap, passes through there, goes up, backed up to the other thimble on the other side, and then the other side knots off right there. Mack Pack has a continuous loop of line here attached to the zipper. So you pull on it, that will open the zipper, and then the sail can be hoisted if the halyard's already on it. When hoisting the sail, if you're not motoring straight into the wind, sometimes it can get fouled up on the lazy jacks here. So in that case, you can pull off the
line on the leeward side on that cleat there. And then just grab the lines all together. Pull them forward and hook them over a cleat or something here. And now they're out of the way. And this cover will be taken off. Remove the center snap and then the upper one. And if you want that down out of your way, it can be tied up here